you keep improving your refutation skills and you keep applying them in real life, it is very likely that you will be confronted at some point to what is called an ad hoc rescue. So what do we mean by that? Let us start with a rather common and potentially perfectly legitimate technique when someone refutes your argument. It is called moving the goalpost. The goalpost is a metaphor for the argument at hand, which is about to be refuted. Let's say it's your opponent's argument. You find a flaw in it. So your opponent changes his argument a bit. Oh, actually, this is not exactly what I meant. Sorry about that. I meant blah, 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 blah. So it's called moving the goalpost because the argument was at some point here and now it's a bit further, it's there. So it's not a fallacy per se. It is sometimes perfectly normal to refine an argument to be more precise with regards to the notions or the premises that you are using. It becomes a fallacy if and only if you move a goalpost based on irrelevant criteria. And then it becomes what is called a no true Scotsman, which is a reference to following dialogue, person A. No Scotsman puts sugar on his porridge. Person B. Oh, but my Uncle Angus is a Scotsman and he puts sugar on his porridge. Person A. But no true Scotsman puts sugar on his porridge. More generally, this technique belongs to the field of what is called ad hoc rescues. Let me give you a real-life example. If someone tells you, I know that fairies exist, I have seen one, and when he or she faces your skepticism, goes on like that, oh, but they only appear to people who believe in them, then it is most definitely an ad hoc rescue, or in the form of a no-true Scotsman. It sounds stupid, but put like that, of course. But trust me, we hear it every day, this kind of argument, for instance, in the field of alternative medicine. I have a classic one in the case of homeopathy. There's always this person that tells you, oh, I was cured from this bad flu in only 2 days thanks to belladonna or whatever homeopathy cure. See, homeopathy actually works. And when, out of skepticism, you reply, oh, I have tried homeopathy several times in my life and I've never healed faster than when I didn't take it. I bet many people would reply something in line of, oh, it is because you do not believe in it. You have to believe in it for it to work. This is a classic ad hoc rescue, a classic no true Scotsman.